Alrighty guys, what's going on? Linky here, and today we're going to be returning to Pokemon Sword and Shield. I didn't want to make this video until the last week came about, and I started to see dozens upon dozens of articles from largely reputable news sources for video game news, speculating and discussing the idea and theory that we're going to be getting a third DLC release for Pokemon Sword and Shield. And it got to the point where I was like, okay, we need to make a video about this because I am firmly in the camp that there is no way, there's no chance that we're getting a third DLC for Sword and Shield. It doesn't even make sense to have the idea that we are. With that being said, let's discuss it. Now, before we jump into the topic today, I just want to note that a lot of you guys are watching these videos and obviously, hopefully enjoying them, but you're not subscribed to the channel. What are you doing? If you enjoy my content, if you like hearing me talk about Pokemon and Nintendo stuff every single week, please be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell so you never miss an upload. It does more than you could realize to support the channel and just allow me to make these videos more often. So with that being said, thank you guys. And let's get right into the topic of me yelling about Pokemon fans yet again. There's been a lot of discussion recently about Pokemon. Not only on this channel, but on YouTube in general and within the Nintendo community, because we're getting towards the time when we're going to be seeing some new announcements. We're getting towards E3 season, we're getting towards the summer months, and we know that games are coming. We know that Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, developed by Ilka Inc., a separate dev, is coming at the end of the year. We know that Game Freak is working on Legends Arceus, an open world, open air Pokemon game, the first time we've ever had one of them. And as of now, it's coming at the beginning of next year. And yet, there seems to be this understanding and this belief among some quote-unquote leakers and sources and some writers of some reputable, and I use reputable loosely, gaming establishments, gaming websites, Twitter accounts, social media accounts, the whole thing, who seem to think that we're going to be getting a third DLC release for Pokemon Sword and Shield. Now, for those of you who do not know, and if you watch this channel, you probably know, Pokemon Sword and Shield came out at the end of 2019. It's the 8th generation of Pokemon. A lot of people felt those games were lacking in terms of content. The next year, Game Freak put out two distinct DLC releases for one price. It was around $24.99 or $28.99, something around there, a little bit under $30 US. And it had two different releases. Earlier in the year, around June or July, the Isle of Armor released. It was an island off the coast of the Galar region that introduced a more like a fighting style dojo campaign where you trained up the mythical Pokemon Kubfu into Urshifu, and you got to challenge this guy named Mustard, who also trained at the champion of Galar, Leon. It introduced a ton of Pokemon from some of the old generations and increased the Pokedex. I believe the Isle of Armor had 200 new Pokemon, and it was a massive open world area. You could basically walk to and go to anywhere that you saw. Of course, they didn't have climbing and those things that you see in other open world games like Breath of the Wild, but it was very open. You could go anywhere. Any land that you could walk upon, you could visit. Any water that you wanted to hop onto, you could go out onto the water and encounter water Pokemon. There were Wailords and Sharpedos. There were some cool mechanics for hunting shiny Sharpedo where they'd charge at you in the water and you could continually reset to find them. There was a lot of cool things. The Isle of Armor was a really nicely designed area. Later on in the year, we got the second piece of this DLC expansion, which was to the south of the Galar region and is connected to mainland Galar via the train station, called the Crown Tundra. This was a more snowy region. In this, you could find a whole bevy of new Pokemon that were from older regions that weren't available in Galar, just as with the Isle of Armor. This one, besides what Isle of Armor focused on, this one focused on legendary Pokemon. You had to deal with the mystical Pokemon Calyrex, the Lord of Harvests, I believe was his name, and he was trying to reclaim his power in this area. On top of that, you could also take part in the Dynamax adventures, and you could find tons of legendary Pokemon at the end of these raid dungeon boss fights with friends. And then you could shiny hunt in them and find a ton of easier shinies in this area, and it was a very well-designed region. On top of that, they hid a bunch of legendary trios within the Crown Tundra. You could find the Regis and Temples. We got brand new Regis. You could find the Three Musketeers. there was a ton here. And for a lot of Pokemon fans, it was exactly what they were hoping for from the original versions of Sword and Shield, a more open-world Pokemon game, a game where you could really explore to your heart's content, one where the story followed when you wanted to engage with it, and that also had some compelling quote-unquote mini-game aspects, like the legendary raid battles. We got this. This came out last year. I get that 2020 wasn't the best year for a lot of people, but this was a really good part of the year, and it was something that we've never seen from Pokemon before. This is the first time that Game Freak ever did DLC. But if we're looking at reality on a linear timeline, following the reveal and the release of the Crown Tundra and the Isle of Armor, we had a Nintendo Presents. Not a Direct, a Presents, because that's their new branding. And they announced a new game that Game Freak is developing. Put Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl aside for just 1 minute, but we'll get back to it. Game Freak has all hands on deck for an open world, fully explorable, brand new Pokemon title called Legends Arceus. You might know about it. We've done some videos on it. I had a video last 2 weeks ago talking about some things about Legends Arceus. We've done a whole host of them. We're expecting news on Legends Arceus in the coming weeks. And yet, you have all of these sources and all of these news outlets trying to tell people, oh, this year we could see a third area, a third expansion for the Pokemon Sword and Shield DLC. It could happen. Why? What part of you thinks that anything we've seen this year means that we're getting a third DLC? Not only have we entered a new cycle of game releases and a new hype season for two titles that have nothing to do with the Galar region, which is the region that Gen 8 takes place in, Sword and Shield, Isle of Armor, the Crown Tundra, we've all but abandoned that. We're fully focused on the Sinnoh region right now. They're celebrating Piplup as a new mascot of Pokemon. Pachima is the Japanese name for Piplup, and they've created a whole new social media account, Bonanza, for Piplup. They're fully celebrating Sinnoh. Why? When Game Freak has now diverted all of their resources to a brand new title taking place in a totally different region with an entirely different concept, why would they come in and say, here's more DLC for Sword and Shield, the game that came out almost 2 years ago? It doesn't make any sense. On top of it, Game Freak, for as much criticism as anybody in the Pokemon community and Nintendo fans as a whole can have for this company for some of the decisions that they've made over the last couple years, they were clearly receptive to a lot of the outcry from some parts of the Pokemon community in the build-up to Sword and Shield. They gave us a ton more Pokemon in the DLC that weren't originally there. We've seen Pokemon Home integration, so you can bring over all of your Pokemon. They have spoken very little of some of the things that they were doing during the build-up and release to Sword and Shield. They fully focused on the DLC areas now, which give a lot of players exactly what they wanted. They brought back Pokemon following you in the DLC areas, something that did not exist in the main story, in the main land of Galar, even in the wild areas in the Galar region. Another criticism that people had of this was in Let's Go, why didn't this get brought over? They have fully shifted their focus and they're developing a brand new game, an incredibly overreaching and franchise-defining game, franchise-changing game. Why would they also take a part of their team and be working on a third DLC? Or why had they already been doing that? This game is seemingly has been in development for some time. For a game as big as this, you'd have to assume that they've taken the formula of splitting their studio in two different groups, an A and a B, which for those of you who don't know, they would do for prior Pokemon games. One team would be working on Sun and Moon, for example, while the other one was working on Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Why would they continue to do that when there's a big, ambitious game that they're working on? They've probably combined their teams, which means who's developing this third DLC that we're seemingly getting? And if it's not coming out next, if it's not coming out this year, are we going to see these same articles come out after Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, maybe around December, saying, oh, 2022, we could see the third DLC. The sources said. These are the same sources who are saying recently, you know, Game Freak's going to do, the Pokemon company is going to do a Pokemon Presents in June. And everyone's acting as if this is major big news. I'm sorry, to my dismay and to my questioning, haven't we seen Pokemon Directs and Pokemon Presents essentially every single June for the last, like, 5 years? barring maybe 2017 or 2015 or excuse me, 15, when we didn't see a Pokemon game. This is not something, these leakers don't have anything. I don't mean to totally discount these leakers, and in 2 weeks, we could have a Pokemon Presents event that they're like, oh, look, we teased. And they can announce a third DLC, and I'm going to look like an idiot. But I'm really confident that I'm not going to look like an idiot. There's no chance that they're going to charge more than what they've already charged us for the base game of Pokemon Sword and Shield and for a DLC expansion pass for a game that's almost 2 years old in a year where we're not only getting remakes of older Pokemon games that are coming out anywhere between September and November of this year, and when we're getting a quote-unquote mainline Pokemon game developed by Game Freak coming out just a few months after that. It doesn't make any sense. And I'm of the opinion, essentially, that any website that's publishing these claims is literally doing it just to get you to click on the article and read it and help their site through ad revenue. They don't believe this. There is not a soul who's writing these articles who genuinely believes we're getting Sword and Shield DLC for a third time. And listen, I loved the DLC. I thought it was great. I thought it was the best part of Sword and Shield, specifically the Crown Tundra and the lore and gameplay mechanics that it introduced and the freedom that it gave to the player, not only to explore the land that they created for us, but also to play through the story at our own leisure. I thought it was great. But we are in a new hype cycle. We are getting ready for brand new games. There is no need, there's no point to releasing third DLC. Not only do I think it would be a mistake if Game Freak did it, I think you'd have a lot of people annoyed because you'd have people going, why are you divesting and diverting your resources away from Legends Arceus when this is probably the thing that the vast majority of the Pokemon community is the most excited for right now? Doesn't make any sense. With that being said, this was a little ranty, but I really wanted to talk about this week because it really got under my skin that so many websites nowadays just clickbait with things just to get people to watch and read, which is really what I think a lot of this third version discussion is. With that being said, let me know what you guys think down below. Do you think we're going to see third DLC for Sword and Shield? Would you even want to see it? And of course, if you're not subscribed to the channel, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. It helps support me, helps me create more content for you guys, and leave a like if you enjoyed this topic, and if you want to see me yell at the video game community more in the future. With that being said, I've been Linky. This has been a very, very irritating discussion to make and be forced into making, pretty much, by how many things I've read. And I will see you all in the next video. Peace out.